The situation we in right now is Africans need to wake up. Wake up, because right now Africans are at war. Because Bill Gates stated that the world population is to be reduced by 3 billion. 3 billion. Where are these 3 billion going to come from?
In Africa is the least populated area in this world.
Yeah.
We have this more than 30 million kilometers square with only 1.6, 1.3 billion people. Is it? So it's a less populated area in this world. I don't know why this issue of depopulation or birth control came to Africa and we Africans accepted it, because we are the ones who are the minority in terms of number compared to the geographical area. And we have a vast land which we haven't exploited.
But on the planet, the melanated man, woman and child, melanated people are the majority.
I know so. But
Africa, so although I and I, hold on there, although Africa is part of the globe, you have a global white supremacy system, right? So how is this white minority ruling the earth, and keeping black people down, and they're trying to elude us about equality and these things. So Rastafari come for free, man, free I and I from that mental slavery.
That
I and I have been programmed into.
And in the Rastafari doctrine, there is this thing of the repatriation and reparation for the damage that was caused to Africa and Africa for the past 500 years. For the benefit of those who don't know about this stuff or misinformed about the repatriation, what is your take on the issue of repatriation? What is real repatriation? Who is responsible for repatriation? Who is responsible to accept that claim that there should be repatriation, there should be reparation and stuff? What is your take on that?
Africans need to know themselves and know the history of the continent. But it's an African continent, so Africans must know their history. If Africa history is being told to them by Europeans, something is wrong. So for example, and I went to the transatlantic slave trade where them come and take Africans from out of Africa and bring them to the West, so-called West, and enslaved I and I. But there was also slavery in the East. Right, where they took ones to the East.
So over in this part of the world,
how come we don't hear these talks? How come these Africans here are not talking about that? That enslavement of Africans. How come I don't hear much talk about it? We hear about the West. But what about the East?
About the East.
All right. You understand what I'm saying? What about that? So this is it. You say Rastafari come to liberate ones, Africans. That's what it's about. And to liberate Africa and uplift Africa and redeem Africa. So when ones are talking about repatriation now and reparation, these are concepts that come before, how can I put it? It's a global principle. It's a principle. I damage you, I come and damage you, I damage your property. I must repair that property.
That's very true.
So that is a
principle. The German are paying something.
So you get defeated in the war.
You pay that.
You pay reparation.
Yeah.
So if you look at the Asian Revolution now, it's the only one I can think and consider where the winners did have to pay reparation. Yeah, to the losers.
Okay, the Haitian now.
Yes.
Paid the French.
You have to pay the French.
Why
pay
so
the American?
Huh? Why so?
Why so? Because I'm telling you, we live in a global white supremacy system.
And I defeat you and I pay you.
And yes, and Haiti is a little island.
I know so.
Yes? So how are you going to trade with the world when we control the ships, we control the economies of these other places? We do not need to trade with you. What happened to you? What happened to your people?
Yes, sir.
They're going to start to die because they're not getting any food. So you need to come to an agreement. Yeah? So they say, all right, you pay us for our losses. Yeah?
Yeah, yeah.
You pay us for our losses. Yeah?
Yeah.
So that is all. Them all down Haiti. Right? Because Haiti defeated them.
Yeah, yeah.
In 1804, the Haitian Revolution. Right?